The rarest gems are formed over time, under pressure, resilient and destined to shine. Every one of them, one of a kind. The time and place to show the world what they're made of and what they want to be. Warriors.
That is stunning.
Challengers.
Wow, that is clutch.
Cinderellas. And champions. This is the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship.
Welcome to Dickey's Arena in Fort Worth, Texas, for our live coverage of the 2023 Women's NCAA Gymnastics Championship. The top eight teams in the country are here. They competed in two separate semifinal sessions on Thursday, with Florida, LSU, Oklahoma, and Utah advancing to today's championship final. Hi, everybody. I'm Bart Connor, along with my fellow Olympic medalist, Kathy Johnson-Clark. Kathy, it all comes down to this. Now, one of the favorites has to be Oklahoma. They've won six of the last nine championships. However, as we have seen, no team is unbeatable.
That statement has never been more true, and that dynamic has pushed these final four teams to all new heights and to their absolute best. Now, Oklahoma has proven all season long their dominance was simply not pulled out of a hat. It's their stacked lineups, their polish, their attention to detail, and most important, their experience at winning championships.
A big story this postseason has centered around the heroic comebacks from injuries from some of the biggest names in the NCAA.
Olympic silver medalist Grace McCallum of Utah hyperextended her knee early in the season, but came back just in time for these championships on two events, and she was outstanding. And Trinity Thomas of Florida, injured, had a lower leg injury, and was not able to train the last several weeks. But look at this. Came back in two events for Florida when they needed her most, and she was stunning.
Trinity Thomas currently has 27 perfect 10s in her career, with a chance to tie or break that record tonight. Now, one of the sentimental stories of the year has been the season-long resilience of LSU. Every time you think they're down, they keep climbing back. For more, here's Sam Pesek.
Yeah, that's right, Bart. LSU has been plagued with injuries so far this season, but they're missing some star power and they're missing some competitive experience in their lineup. But what's impressive to me is that despite all the adversity, they still continue to rise in the rankings. Head coach Jay Clark told the team, "We might be Cinderella in a wheelchair, but we're still Cinda-dang-rella, so you better act like it." One of the seniors quickly chimed in and said, "If the clock strikes three and the ring fits, we're gonna wear it." So you expect to see a lot of heart from this LSU team here today.
All right, the stage is set. We have a great crowd in hand at Dickey's Arena. The national champion will be crowned in less than 2 hours from now. Stay with us, folks. And we are set for the start of the 2023 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship. And just a reminder, you can watch every event from every team on ESPN Plus. You get commentary on each stream from our in-house gymnasts that we call the Stream Team. We have John Rotzesberger, Ashley Miles Greig, Bridget Sloan. We'll have you covered all day long on ESPN Plus. There's also a Spanish feed available as well. Unfortunately, Kennedy Baker is not feeling her best, so she's unable to be with us today. We will miss her, but we have an outstanding lineup of some of the best gymnasts in U.S. history to commentate today. Reminder how the format works in the quad meet. Four teams will compete simultaneously, all four apparatus going at the same time. Six gymnasts will compete on each team on each event, with just the top five scores counting towards their team total. There are six judges in the national championship. High and low scores are dropped, and four scores in the middle will be averaged. A lot of scrutiny here and a lot of pressure, especially in this first rotation. That is Danny Severs, who gets the honor to lead off for the Oklahoma Sooners in the first rotation.
The number one ranked team on this event is Oklahoma. They need to put money in the bank here and start off with a stick, if at all possible. A very difficult 1.5 twist. That's a 10-0 start value vault. And the last second step on the landing is really the only deduction there.
Here's Sloane Blakely, was outstanding on beam in the semifinals after struggling a bit on the bars. The beam leadoff spot, Kathy, might be the most critical performance in all of college gymnastics.
Absolutely. It's the leadoff batter. They must set the pace. They have to get on base. And in gymnastics, getting on base is a 9-9 plus.
Abby Brenner for Utah on floor in the right side of your screen.
Sloane Blakely, so phenomenally solid so far in this routine.
Florida talks a lot about competing at your best in terms of red, blue, and green zones. Red is when you're stressed, green is laughing, having fun, and blue is the most focused. The reason Sloane Blakely is in this spot is because she competes in the blue zone the best. She nailed, like you said, Bart, the most crucial routine for Florida. They're off to a good start, and she's celebrating it.
I'll say that was the blue zone, and she hit the target on the floor like a dart.
Fascinating story with Abby Brenner. She competed as a part of Michigan's national championship team a couple of years ago, but taking her graduate year now, competing for Utah as we go to vault for Allie Stern for the Sooners.
Another 1.5 twist for Oklahoma. Hop on the landing. Abby Brenner finishing up on floor. That is perfect controlled landing on that tumbling pass. The judges really look for that control for no deduction. Great start for Utah, and Utah was stunning in the semifinals. They put so much pressure on Oklahoma.
Ashley Cowan, she has stepped up for LSU. Alexis Jeffrey, the transfer from UCLA, led them off on bars with a strong 9.8375.
Opens with a difficult combination, that Ray, the single bar release on the high bar, right into the transition to low. Let's see if she can get this landing. It's a double layout. Watch for the shape in the air. Perfectly executed in the air. Just that step on the landing. Those can add up.
We have documented LSU's story all year long. They've asked this team to continue to dig, and athletes have stepped up in the lineup. Without four of their biggest names, they're still here in the championship final with a shot. Kat Lavasser now, the junior from San Antonio, Texas, up for the Sooners. Allie Stern, the fifth-year senior, got a 9-9 after Danny Severs led them off with a 9.8625. Vault has been a strong event for the Sooners in the last several years.
Absolutely. Their technique is superb. Their amplitude superior. And Kat has dialed in these landings so many times throughout the season. Does not get it here. Gets that big step forward.
Ellie Lazari on beam for Florida after Sloane Blakely led off the Gators with an outstanding 9-9.
Ellie is one of the calmest.
Wow.
Usually the calmest, coolest competitor on beam.
The pressure of the championship final. A fall off beam is a half a point deduction. Remember, six athletes compete. You'll count just the best five scores towards their team total, but that puts pressure on the rest of the lineup as Jaylene Gilstrap from Utah takes to the floor after Abby Brenner got a 9.875.
Opens with a front layout to a Rudy, a 1.5 twist, a little bit of a hop back. Jaylene is an absolutely stunning dancer. This is where she shines. Look at the extension and the full split in those leaps.
Gilstrap, the junior from McKinney, Texas, one of many gymnasts in this NCAA championship from Texas clubs. Jordan Bowers now for the Sooners on vault after Kat Levasseur got a 9.8875.
Oklahoma needs a stick. Not quite, just that little step. You haven't seen one yet.
Lou Ball, the associate head coach for the Sooners, looking for at least a couple of sticks on vault for the Sooners to have a chance to win this.
Front lay to front full. Beautiful control and an absolutely stunning flare of a finish. Well done.
Coverage of the NCAA championships continues with our men's gymnastics championship later tonight at 6 Eastern on NCAA.com. For more information, go to NCAA.com, your home for all 90 NCAA championships. Take a look at what happened to Ellie Lazzari on beam after Sloane Blakely led them off with a 9-9.
It goes without saying, this is, beam is narrow. She had a little stutter step in between those two layout step outs that just threw off. Sometimes that can change your timing.
You mentioned the beam is narrow. It's just a little bit wider than your average cell phone. It's 4 inches wide, 16 feet long. And Kayla DiCello, how do you characterize her contribution to the team this year for Florida?
Well, her superpower, as we see for Faith Torres on vault.
Oh, there's their first stop.
Boy, she has muscles in her teeth. I'm telling you, she held on to that stick so hard.
My.
Her quads are going to be hurting tomorrow. That's crazy.
Jordan Bowers, before you, had the second 9-9 for the Sooners, but that is their first clear-cut stuck landing.
And back to Kayla. You asked about her contribution. The thing that she loves about college gymnastics and the team aspect is this pressure. She came off beam one time and said to Coach Jenny Rowland, because it was under immense pressure, just like this, after a fall, and she says, I love this. I was like, oh, that's money.
The lowest scoring event for the Gators in the semifinals was beam. So remember, six athletes are competing. You count the best five scores. The score for Ellie Lazzari is only a 9.0125, so everyone else in the lineup has to hit for Florida to come out of this first rotation with a good team score.
Double bowl. I love the calmness I'm seeing on her face. On this event, you have to have just the right combination of calm and aggressive attack.
Abby Paulson on floor for Utah at the same time. They have two 9.875s on Utah's floor scores.
Here's the acro series on beam. Watch closely. So solid. Great open tumbling run. 2.5 twist.
Talk about the quality of gymnastics we're seeing. DiCello, world championship all-around bronze medalist. So those of you who hadn't seen gymnastics in a while, these gymnasts are not only the best in the country, but some of them are the best in the world.
Great reset routine for Florida. They needed that.
Kathy, we saw a lot of nerves in the semifinals, but the team seemed to be settled down today.
And the team that showed the least amount of nerves was Utah. They were really spectacular in the semis. And their gymnastics is so impressive, so clean. Back 1.5 twist to front layout.
Abby Paulson is one of the senior six-pack, as her head coach Tom Farden says a moment ago on bars. Aaliyah Finnegan, LSU, yet to break into the 9-9s on this event, but this is one of the best in the country.
Watch this monster combination. Piked Delchev, beautifully done, so difficult. And look how aggressively she is attacking these vertical handstand positions, so important. And the all-important dismount right here with the landing. It's an Arabian double front, very difficult to stick.
Ooh.
Step forward, that's the really main deduction in that routine.
And moments ago for the Sooners on vault, Olivia Troutman after Faith Torres got a 9.925. So they have three scores already, 9.9 or better on one of the Sooners' best events.
We saw Olivia drill this landing in the semis to win this event. And there it is again. She is uncanny. That is her middle name from now on.
The fifth-year senior delivers again, the reigning national champion as of the semifinals, hits a solid 9.95 for the Sooners. What an anchor competitor.
Li-Ann Wong just did beautiful leaps. So secure on this back handspring layout step out.
Li-Ann Wong got two 10s on beam this season, her first 10s on beam in her career. I asked her what changed for her, and she said she's really figuring out how to have more fun, and that's been the key that's been helping her gymnastics. It looks pretty incredible to me, Kathy.
Oh, it does. She is so well-trained. Her basics are phenomenal on this event, and that's what you can rely on.
Former world all-around silver medalist in 2021.
Double twist right here. Oh, and held onto the stick. It's a little quick to the salute, so the judges could take a slight deduction there for that, but a beautifully executed beam routine.
Congratulations there from Owen Field and Jenny Rowland, who is the head coach at Florida.
I love this angle, showing you just how narrow that beam is and how you have to punch the end of the beam with both feet. Somersault, two twists, awesome.
Haley Bryant set to go on bars for LSU. Now the Oklahoma Sooners have their score of 49.5625. Vault goes faster than the other events, so they're basically the leader in the clubhouse. LSU cannot catch Oklahoma, but Florida and Utah still can in this rotation.
Watch the amplitude on this release move. Well done on the straddle Jaeger.
No score 9.9 or better yet for the LSU Tigers here in this bar event.
That was a beautiful bail to handstand, that transition to the low bar, and again right on top, showing off that handstand position. Watch the double front with the half twist and a perfectly stuck landing.
Outstanding. The bronze medalist in the all-around 2 days ago. How do you characterize what she does for this team?
She is an absolute beast, physically, mentally, every aspect of her athletic accomplishment is just a thing of beauty.
There's Jay Clark. He's hopping around. He knows he's got a good start for the LSU Tigers.
Yeah, guys, she didn't even practice the week leading up to Nationals because her shoulder was hurting so bad. But head coach Jay Clark said that after her teammate Kaya Johnson went down, she just had a different look in her eye, and she's extremely focused. It's different than any other year.
Expect a score of 9.9 or better would be the first for LSU in that opening rotation. Here is Riley McCusker coming after Li-Ann Wong got a 9.9125. What a story. McCusker, former national team member, did not compete much last year or this season, and she has really come on of late.
Beautiful double wolf turn. She has been outstanding in nearly every routine she's performed thus far, and it's been toward the end of the season that she's really gotten this confidence. Front aerial, this is where she had trouble in semis, no problem here. Watch the details in this routine. She has an exquisite toe point. Back handspring layout step out, so elegant.
After McKenna Smith got a 9.925 for Utah on floor, here is Jaden Rucker.
So far, this is one of the most beautiful beam routines I've seen all week long. Jaden Rucker with a full twisting double back and a little off balance. And the dismount gainer full for Riley. Well done.
You notice the gymnasts using those supplemental mats for the landing. They're allowed to do that to protect their ankles. And on floor, it's necessary to tape that quarter-inch mat or that sting mat or four-incher so that they still know where the out-of-bounds line is. Because if you go out of bounds, it's 1/10 of a point deduction, which could be the difference between a championship or not.
The last passes are combination pass. You'll see two somersaults in this pass. First is a straight layout into a front with a full.
You see Utah's scores. They're averaging 9-9 so far in this opening rotation. What a start. Rucker, the former NCAA vault champion last year, does her part, and she sets up her teammate, Miley O'Keefe, who herself has won 4 NCAA titles.
So this was a first pass, full twisting double back. She was just a little off balance, so she had that little extra arm swing, but covered it pretty darn well.
Oh, this is important for the Florida Gators on beam in this next rotation. Riley McCusker hit her routine. Remember, they have a miss, a 9-0-1-2-5 that they'd like to replace, but it all depends on what Victoria Wynn does here in this anchor spot. Riley McCusker got their high score of a 9-9-3-7-5, but Florida's fate may come down to whether she sticks this routine.
And Bart, to up the ante, she has not been in the beam lineup much this season at all, so immense pressure.
Yesterday they had Peyton Richards in the anchor spot. Today they elected to put Victoria Wynn, the transfer from Georgia.
Opens with her acrobatic series here. Anody into a back handspring, kept that moving beautifully.
Miley O'Keefe starting on floor for Utah after Jaden Rucker. Got another 9-9 over there.
And this is side-by-side, beautiful gymnastics. Both of these gymnasts are exquisite in their presentation. Miley combines all the beauty of her dance and the power and finesse in her tumbling. Nice form in that pike double back. Here's the dismount for Victoria.
Oh,
and
my goodness.
Boy, they are going to be celebrating over there.
A 9-9-2-5 for Victoria Wynn for that beam routine would allow Florida to pass Oklahoma in this first rotation. What a clutch hit for Victoria Wynn when they needed it most.
You can see why Miley was able to win the all-around. Here, she is such a complete gymnast. Combination pass here, difficult. Back, 1.5 twist to a front layout. Dances right out. Just lovely, as always.
So Florida continues the momentum from the semifinals.
Watch the form and the finesse. It's not the most difficult pass in the competition, but she does it so exquisitely well. Great technique, shows those shapes, the ideal shape in those skills that the judges are looking for.
She's won the all-around and 3 of the individual events in the NCAA championship over her career, the senior out of Las Vegas. All right, Florida had a clutch hit on beam there in that rotation. Sam is with their head coach, Jenny Rowland, now.
A lot of excitement over here on beam, a lot of drama. What was going through your head from the back half of the lineup having to fight back after a fall?
This team has been doing a fantastic job all year on beam. They have dealt with adversity along the way. Today was no different. We did have a different anchor in today. And kudos to Victoria for stepping in and doing what she needed to do, and that's just be yourself.
I think I saw everybody on the Florida team jump 2 feet in the air when she landed. How do you keep this momentum going to the next event?
The shoes help for sure, the tennis shoes, but right now it's resetting, taking our breath, taking our step forward, and continuing to be us.
Thanks, Jenny.
Thank you.
Talk about how close this one is. Florida, Oklahoma, and Utah are all separated by 625 ten-thousandths of a point. The NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
A huge topic of conversation over the recent years has been the dominance of OU gymnastics. So join me in taking a little ride on the Sooner Schooner to see how it all started. KJ Kindler was named head coach in 2006. She became a two-time national head coach of the year. And she recruited a couple of recent superstars in Maggie Nichols and Anastasia Webb, who each won individual event titles. Every season since 2013, and even more impressive is that they've won the last 5 of 8 championships. And I watched warm-ups today, and guys, they're dialed in and hungry for another win.
We just went out there and we gave it all we got, and we kept fighting and fighting, and that really showed, like, our tenacity.
I thought they were good. You know, we just weren't great. We weren't hitting every single landing. But I did think they competed hard. I did think they were dialed in. I thought the energy was really good. What's really important is that we qualified on and have the opportunity to win a national championship. I do think that it's motivating. There's no doubt about it.
Olivia Troutman, their secret weapon.
I'm just excited to enjoy all those moments, do my best gymnastics, watch my team do their best gymnastics.
We're ready and we're hungry for more and going out for day two and really just focusing on those details and doing exactly what we know that we can do.
Fifth-year senior Olivia Troutman is known as the closer because she always tends to miss the beginning of season due to an injury and comes back to lead her team to victory in the postseason. It's no different this year. She's been a huge asset to the team since coming back from a leg injury. She even won an individual event title on vault. And she's in good company with all the other event winners. UCLA's Jordan Childs is already an Olympic silver medalist, but now she can add NCAA bars and floor champion to her resume. And Utah's Miley O'Keefe had an impressive showing. She needed a perfect 10 to win the beam and all-around title and got the job done. What an animal. Utah's hoping for a repeat performance here tonight.
And welcome back to Fort Worth. Bart Connor, Kathy Johnson-Clark, and Sam Peschick on the call. But just a reminder, you can watch every event from every team on ESPN Plus. You'll get commentary from each stream from our in-house gymnasts that we call the Stream Team. John, Ashley, and Bridget will have you covered all day long on ESPN Plus. There's also a Spanish feed available. What a start to this championship final. The four top teams in the country who qualified here, they are enormously close. In fact, three teams have a 9.9 or better average after the first rotation. LSU struggled a bit on bars, and so they are going to have to rally on beam in the second event. The Sooners move from vault. They have the lead. They move to the bars here in rotation two. On floor, Victoria Wynn, who gave them a clutch routine on beam, is their leadoff on floor for the Gators.
And Oklahoma is number one on the bars, Florida number two on floor. This is going to be a great rotation. Look at the start with Oklahoma. These are great handstands and holds on to the stick. And I hope you caught a glimpse of that tumbling pass right there. That was phenomenally executed, very clean. Victoria, so beautiful as we saw on balance, brings that same elegance and presentation to this gorgeous floor routine, epic music.
Kathy, you know, not every gymnast can pull off a classical presentation like this.
I love it. It's gorgeous. And the style suits her so much to a T. And the tumbling is there. Judges are looking for those controlled landings. And a beautiful flourish. And of course, the Gator chomp for Florida.
So Victoria Wynn with two big hit routines as she gets congratulations from their associate head coach, Adrian Bourde, 17 years with the program. Abby Brenner will be up on the vault for Utah. As I mentioned, she was part of Michigan's national championship team a couple of years ago, and this is one of the reasons they're excited to have her on Utah's team, because this is an event where they needed to get a little bit better, and boy, they have improved.
What a gift. She should have come with a bow. This one-and-a-half twist, if she can get this landing, is so important to Utah. Awesome job. And she never gets too excited. That's the
now, Miley O'Keefe led them off with a 9.7375. So they need better scores here if they're going to contend for the championship today. It may come down to vault landings for the Utah Red Rocks. Danae Fletcher, Oklahoma. Danny Sievers led them off with a 9.925. That's why they're the number one team in the country. KJ Kindler told us earlier, we need to start every rotation with a 9.9 or better if we're going to win.
So far, big difficulty in this routine. That high bar release skill was an E-rated skill. The dismount here. Full twist and double back and another stiff.
Kathy, you mentioned an E-rated skill. The skills are ranked from A to E, the A being the easiest, the E being the most difficult.
And your top teams, they're going to be throwing a lot of those E skills on all events.
Victoria Wynn led off the Gators with a 9.8875. Here is Sloan Blake.
Very important tumbling pass right here. Arabian double front. She needs to, back 1.5 to a front layout. Normally does that Arabian double front here. She switched up her tumbling.
At a 9.85 in the semifinal.
She's going to get
from Frisco, Texas.
Her bonus points in these leaps. These are very difficult leaps.
On beam for LSU, Alona Shenikova. Now, Elena Arenas led off the LSU Tigers on beam with only a 9.475. So LSU needs to be solid for the last five routines if they're going to come away with a good score in rotation two.
Alona told me that every time she gets nervous in a competition, which I'm guessing is maybe right about now, she thinks of what Kim Mulkey said to her. Of course, Kim just won the NCAA championships for the first time as the head coach of the LSU women's basketball team. She said, play as if you're behind. Those words really help keep this team going, and especially Alona, when they're training and competing in tough situations here.
And Sam, I'm sure you saw how she just finessed that landing out of the Acro series. Made it work. She was a little hesitant on those leaps. That's just a little bit of nerves there.
LSU has been runner-up in three of the last six championships. Ninth time in the finals this year.
This is a solid reset routine. Here's the dismount, back handspring, swing through to gain her full. And a stick, well done, because that was a lot of pressure she was feeling right there, and she managed it.
LSU has won the SEC championship several times, but they are the only team in today's final who have not won a national championship. The Sooner have won six of the last nine championships. Olivia Trautman coming after Danae Fletcher got a 9.9125.
Open with Maloney to pack Salto down to the low bar. Slightly over on that half pirouette, just a little off vertical. Love her technique. Nice straight body work. Giant swings into a gorgeous double layout. She may have scooted those feet forward a little bit on the landing, but the shape in the air was so beautiful. Judges sit right on the side, so they get to see the laid out shape. Here we can see that she keeps those legs together.
Trautman, the senior from Minnesota, eight-time All-American herself, doing her part. Jaden Rucker now.
Last year's national champion on this event, and we have seen her come up big time for Utah. An uncanny number of sticks.
They're going to need a good vault here because they have two scores in the 9.7s. Abby Brenner has their best score of 9.9, but she can do a big vault here.
Big in the air. Couldn't quite hold on to that stick. Sometimes when you're trying to stick, you can come up just a little bit short because you have to take that risk to lay it out to go for the stick.
Rachel Bauman on floor now for Florida. And Reagan Smith on bars for the Sooners as Olivia Trautman's score comes in with a 9.95.
Reagan, such a dynamic performer on the ending bars. There's your perfect half pirouette on low bar. See if she can get the stick on this double layout. Oh, oh. Just a little shuffle of the feet. Rachel Bauman is such a beauty on this event. Just beautiful footwork, so precise.
Bauman, the graduate student from Plano, Texas, the sister of Alyssa Bauman, who was a legend at Florida.
Just epic leaps. That is so, they're so high and so well executed. She ends this routine with a pike double back. She was a little forward and short of rotation in the semis. She needs to land this perfectly. Much better.
The last vaulter for Utah is Jaylene Gilstrap after Jaden Rucker had a 9.8375. Only 1.99 or better for Utah here.
This is a full, so it's a 9.95 start bang. You could see her foot landed over that line. It's not an automatic deduction, but those lines are there to show the judges whether they've gone directly in line and stayed straight with the table, and she's a little off center.
Jordan Bauer is set to take to the bars now for the Sooners. They have four hit routines. You can see her season average. That NQS number is your national qualifying score based on your average scores throughout the season. 10th in the NCAA ranked on this event. This is a superb event for the Sooners.
And Bart, I'm looking at the fierce focus in her eyes. This is the way she competes. So laser focused on all those cues, and she can attack this bar routine aggressively with big swing, big skills.
There's three performers all over 9.9. Reagan Smith scores in a 9.8875.
Watch how she rotates this release skill. Coming up after the half pirouette here, big giant straddle Jaeger. Gets that good rotation, reaches out for the regrasp. Impressive form, legs glued together. Shows off the final handstand and the dismount. Just a double back and has miles to see the floor to spot that landing.
Lou Ball knows it's a good one for the sophomore from Lincoln, Nebraska. She scored twice, perfect tens on the bars. Peyton Richards now.
Double A out here. Little bit of a bouncy landing. They'll hope to take a slight deduction there.
Rachel Bauman before her had the first 9.9 for the Florida Gators. To put this in perspective, Oklahoma has three scores and likely four scores 9.9 or better in this second rotation. No other team has a score of 9.9 plus in rotation two other than the Sooners. Sarah Ballard for LSU on beam after Alexis Jeffrey got a 9.825. Their high score there so far.
Final pass for Peyton, back one and a half, front full, well done. Sierra Ballard solid as can be on that acro series. Very strong routine for Florida. Just that first landing on the tumbling pass.
Peyton Richards, who trains by herself in the mornings at Florida because of her demanding class schedule. The coaches come in and work with her alone, making a good contribution there on Florida.
Oh, so aggressive. She was slightly off to the left, but boy, did she pull that right back on. No problem.
Sierra Ballard has been struggling with a sore ankle.
And has been tough as nails throughout.
Yeah, her enthusiasm is just electric.
great routine for her. Just the step on that landing, so tough.
Audrey Davis on bars after Jordan Bowers got another 9.925 for the Sooners.
This is a breathtaking routine from the level of difficulty, unique skills, perfect technique, and execution throughout.
This is the kind of routine that can score a 10.
It's gorgeous. That Higgins roll. Now watch this. Double front with a half twist.
Oh!
And drills the landing. So
oh, my goodness.
You and I both are such fans of her work on bars. We know how difficult the skills are, how great her technique is. Her swing is so effortless. I mean, to be elegant on bars, it's just so gorgeous. So difficult to keep those legs together on that dismount.
You're not kidding. The junior from Frisco, Texas. Oh, what a thrill for the Sooners. Only one score below 9.9, and Audrey Davis's will easily be 9.9 plus as Leanne Wong takes to the floor. Peyton Richards for the Gators had a 9.875. They need big scores to stay on pace with the Sooners here.
Oh! No, and a big jump out of bounds. She'll get a tenth of a point for going out of bounds, and the out of control step is another deduction.
Rachel Bauman is their only score of 9.9 or better in this rotation. Sooners trying to pad their lead here.
Front with a full, there's that control. Oh, so the mistake on the landing of the first pass was gonna cost her. It certainly did diminish the beauty of the routine, but it is a deduction.
Haley Bryant now up for LSU. They have 2 9.825s in a row from Jeffrey and Ballard. Bryant has been money all season long, especially when they're under pressure.
You read my mind, Bart. She has just been so tough in every single situation. So consistent, and that doesn't come by luck. This is an athlete who is trained and prepared for this season. She truly has been beastly in her approach to every single routine that she has performed. Standing front up, ooh, a little bit leg up. Anytime you lift a leg to correct your balance or to keep from losing your balance, it's a deduction.
LSU is in this championship after a thrilling regional where they tied with Michigan but earned the spot based on a tie-breaking procedure.
Love this dismount. Punch front, Rudy. Just a slight scoot at the end.
The first round of the NBA playoff continues tomorrow afternoon with Ja Morant and the second-seeded Grizzlies hosting LeBron and the seventh-seeded Lakers in game one of their series right here on ABC at 3 Eastern. Our coverage starts a half hour earlier with the NBA countdown. Kayla DiCello in that anchor spot for Florida, and boy, do they need a big score now. Leanne Wong only a 9.725 as she went out of bounds. Sooners solidly in the lead with a 99.2. You see Florida trails them. The score they're trying to replace is the 9.725, the lowest of their scores.
Every detail is going to matter. Really wants to try to keep form on this front double twist. Can be a really difficult skill to keep those legs straight and not crossed.
Horton leaps here, switch ring to a switch half.
Cello, the freshman from Boyds, Maryland. Competed on the U.S. national team, and now she's just thriving in college competition where the rules are a little bit different.
It's a difficult turn. It's called a wolf turn. She does a double.
More difficulty required in international competition. NCAA competition is more about execution and perfection.
Very precise on that landing. You can see her fighting for every tenth of a point she can get. Really well done.
Aaliyah Finnegan will go on beam after Haley Bryant scored their highest score, 9.85, but LSU yet to break into the 9.9s in this second rotation.
This is a routine that has more difficulty than is required, that candle mount with a half twist. She also does a triple series coming up right here. That's three skills in a row. Back handspring to two layouts. So solid. There was a little slight check. That's all. She held, kept her cool.
She had a perfect February. She scored four perfect tens in four consecutive meets in the month of February this year. The sophomore from Lee's Summit, Missouri, and the sister of LSU All-American Sarah Finnegan.
And Barthes with beautiful leaps. Really showed off the full extension, the full split. And the judges, you can see them right there. They're sitting on the side of the beam, so they can see these shapes. They can see if the legs stay straight throughout the entire skill. So far, this is so solid. See her talking to herself all the way to the very end. And a stick holds on to it on that gainer pull.
Oh, and an essential hit routine. There's her sister. LSU fans, they do travel well, and they are here. The one team in this final that hasn't won a national championship. Will they have enough this year? I think they're just happy to be here, considering the adversity they had faced all year long. All right, Utah off to an outstanding start in this competition, and Sam is with their head coach, Tom Barton.
Thanks, Bart. Tom, your team scored slightly below your team average on vault. Couldn't quite get those landings. Yeah. What do you see from your team there?
You know, we were just going after those sticks a little bit too hard, a little tight. A couple of ones were under-rotated. But otherwise, the amplitude was still there. You're just coming out of the vault just a fraction early.
I saw you huddle up your team. What's the message to them heading into bars?
Well, we don't have anything to lose. You know, we're sitting here, and that wasn't an ideal vault rotation for us. I thought floor went well, and so what do we have to lose? Let's just, swing for the fence and see where it takes us.
Thanks, Tom.
Okay, thanks. Go Utes.
We talk about LSU. They thought they were getting healthy with the return of KJ Johnson, but she re-injured her foot in Thursday's semifinal. The Tigers talk to us about how they're continuing to fight through injuries when we come back.
We're playing with all house money now. I don't want people to stop doubting us. I want everybody to continue to doubt us. I think it's fueled our fire in many ways.
This season has been a climb. We've been clawing, we've been crawling, we've been, scratching to get to the end of it. We've made it, we didn't stop, we didn't give up once.
I have all the faith in this team. All the outsiders didn't think we could do it, but we really kind of like the underdog mentality.
Our theme is this year, we're still climbing and we've made it to the final mountain. Now it's just one more to go.
KJ has not done a lot of floor routines since that foot injury. You see her walking off there and kind of favoring that foot.
In my conversations with KJ afterwards, she said to me, Jay, I wouldn't have done it any other way. I got to help my team go to the finals. She said, you tell us to have no regrets, that I have none.
Yeah, head coach Jay Clark said every time the wheels have fallen off, the team figures out a way to be successful because they refuse to fail. So they're going to empty everything they have in the tank and see what happens. And Florida's Trinity Thomas is competing tonight. Big news since she endured a lower leg injury 2 weeks ago. Decision is complete, and she's going to show up and see how she feels. NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championships returns after this message and a word from our ABC station.
The meet was definitely a roller coaster. We definitely had to fight and show how much grit we had as a team.
People are gonna have great days and bad days, but it's how you bounce back and how you keep moving. On my mind, there was never any shift that we weren't going to make it.
We always talk about having each other's backs, and it sometimes pays off to be a goldfish.
We're no strangers to adversity, and we know how to fight, and that's exactly what we had to do and what we'll keep doing, just knowing that we have each other's backs through everything. I'm just blessed to be in that position on a team like this.
We're gonna make the most of this opportunity and this moment.
I think sometimes people count us out, and we're okay with that because we're good at proving people wrong.
One of the big stories of Florida, of course, is the fate and the status of Trinity Thomas. 2 weeks ago, she hurt her lower right leg in the regional, and now she has been poised to set the NCAA career perfect 10 record. She has 27, and she has two more chances tonight because she's expected to be in vault and bars in the final two rotations for Florida that trails Oklahoma. Just a reminder, you can watch every event from every team on ESPN+. You'll get commentary on each stream from our in-house gymnast that we call the Stream Team. John, Ashley, Bridget, we'll have you covered all day long on ESPN+. There's also a Spanish feed available. Utah on bars in this rotation. Emily Morgan, the British national team member, as Tom Farden, the head coach there, gets set to cheer her on. Boy, they were clutch on bars yesterday. That allowed them to score over 198, their best score in regional history, and win the semifinal.
They were. I hope they bottled that and can uncork it right here because they need it. A little bit awkward on that very difficult. The hard was, that's a interesting pack salto down to the low. Maybe a teensy bit short on that final handstand, but she can make up right here, get the stick. No, a little bit of a hop there, so just tiny things throughout that routine.
Jenna Dunn, her entire career in that leadoff spot for the Sooners on beam.
And she has been magnificent. Oh, in that leadoff spot, just a balance correction there. You saw her lean to the left and slight break at the hips.
At a 9.9125 in the qualifying round 2 days ago.
Last rotation, really the only team that didn't compete tight was Oklahoma. And if they can just loosen up a little bit here to stay calm and yet still aggressive.
Oklahoma has a lead of a quarter of a point, but remember, they're ahead of Florida, but Florida's already done beam.
And Oklahoma is ranked number two on this event, the only team here ahead of them. Of course, that number one, Utah, which will finish on beam.
Moments ago on vault.
Leanne Long does a really difficult vault, very complex. The round-off entry onto the board and then half twist on. Front pike with a half twist off. That is one of her best all season. Perfect time to pull that out.
You're not kidding. And Florida does need some solid landings here if they're going to contend with the Sooners.
Really nicely done. Short hop on the landing, but nice in the air and really high level of difficulty on the vault.
Abby Brenner now for Utah on bars. Brenner, the graduate student, competed with Michigan, and she entered the transfer portal to extend her career one more year. She was picked up by Utah, and she's been an integral part of their championship run this year.
Yeah, I watched Abby Brenner in the Utah Corral after they didn't have their greatest vault performance, and she was the one hyping the team up, getting the energy involved, and that's just one of the reasons that head coach Tom Farden says he won the lottery in the transfer portal. It's much more than gymnastics for Abby Brenner.
Without a doubt, that's the leadership that they needed in that moment. And so far, she is doing her job. Double layout here. Watch the shape in the air and the landing. Look how high her chest is on that landing. That's really well executed.
Let's go!
She's from Maple Grove, Minnesota, but did much of her club training in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Sloane Blakely now set to go for the Gators.
Now Sloane has been a little bit hot and cold. She sat down this vault at regionals, but has come back strong. She's very, very capable of a big 1.5 twist here, and they need it.
At a 9-8 in the qualifying round 2 days ago. This was the second lowest scoring event for Florida in the semifinals after their struggle on beam. They are such a deep team, and Sloane Blakely, a big part of that, can help them here as Olivia Troutman on beam for the Sooners.
Acro series, look for straight hips, straight shoulders. Oh, a little uncharacteristic mistake there on that layout. Needs to really get back into the groove of this routine. Well done on the, oh, until the landing. Pike front toss, that leg up. Just got two balance breaks so far in the routine. Here's Sloane with the 1.5 twist. 10-0 start value. Needs the landing right here. Nice amplitude. A hop forward, but that was a really well executed vault in the air. Big height, good distance.
Sage Thompson for Utah on bars.
Really milked that final handstand, trying to show that off. Nice toe point on those giant swings and into the double layup, holds onto the stick.
Paige Thompson, who really specializes in bars for Utah.
Watch all the little things. The judges are looking for the straight legs, the pointed toes throughout, and they sit right on the side. They can really see the shapes of these skills. That double layout and the chest up high on the landing, really well done.
She posted a 9.9125 in last year's NCAA final, scored a perfect 10 in the regular season against Minnesota. Kayla DiCello now. The high score for Florida is the leadoff score of Leanne Wong.
This is the first season that Kayla's been doing this 1.5 twist. Each meet, it has gotten more and more secure. One of her better vaults all season long. Really impressed by that distance from the table. Little deduction for the hop forward.
Florida trailing Oklahoma, trying to stay loose, but they do need to stick some landings. Jenny Rowland, their head coach, knows it. Florida has won the national championship 3 times, but never under the leadership of Jenny Thompson. Jenny Rowland, who's in her 8th season. And she's had a magnificent team and none more spectacular than this young lady, Trinity Thomas, who will go down in history as one of the greatest collegiate gymnasts of all time. Not at her best because she's only competing in a couple of events here because of her injury, but what a clutch vault she did in the semifinals.
Without a doubt. Keep in mind, she has not been able to train much. She has focused on the physical therapy, getting all of that she could to just be healthy, heal. So what she is relying on are her good basics, the training, years and years of training, so she can dial it in here.
Are you kidding me?
Exactly the way she planned it.
Oh, my. The last year's NCAA all-around champion. We weren't sure how much she was going to contribute because of her injury 2 weeks ago. And of all things, with a lower leg injury, she drills a ball.
I can't tell you how hard it is to stay patient in the air to let that landing happen and then absorb it.
She has 27 perfect tens. The record is 28. They're on their feet here because guess what, folks? One of the greatest of all time, Trinity Thomas, ties the NCAA record for perfect tens. Well deserved. And never coming at a better time for the Florida Gators than the team final. There it is. She ties Jamie Dancer from UCLA and Jenny Hansen from Kentucky with the most perfect tens in the NCAA all time. Oh, this is a movie script, Kathy.
I'm speechless. The guts it took for her to go out and do this. Look at the form, the amplitude, the height, the distance. She's 7.5 feet away from the table. This is just awe-inspiring performance right there.
Oh, she's got it all. She's got the power, the form, the technique.
And the grace.
And the grace. And the grit. Very little vaulting of the last 2 weeks because of her injury, and she just steps up and drills a perfect 10. One more event. We'll see her on the bars in the final rotation. But she's already continuing to make history in the NCAA.
Crystal Issa for Utah on bars here. Hitting those handstand positions. Fighting for every, I'd say, quarter tenth of a point here. Watch this dismount combination. Very difficult. Giant fall into a double layout. Oh, she fought. She fought so hard on that. Her knees were bent just a little deeply in that stick position, but she held on.
The high score for Utah on bars is Sage Thompson's 9.9375, followed by Miley O'Keefe's 9.925. Moments ago on vault, after Trinity Thomas scored her perfect 10, Victoria Wynn.
Only the second time in this vault lineup performing a 1.5 twist. She hit it yesterday, or in the semifinals. Oh, really nicely done. They've got to be so happy with that vault rotation.
They added that extra half twist for the difficulty value.
Absolutely. It's an extra half a tenth of a point. Doing a full would be a 9.95 start value. That's a 10.0 start value.
What a moment for the Gators following up that perfect 10. And the Sooners unfazed. On beam, this is Faith Torres.
Look at that beautiful form and technique on the side aerial layout step out. It's a really difficult acro series done well.
Jordan Bowers has their high score. They're in 9.9125, but the other scores in the 9.8 range.
Nice amplitude on those leaps. When you see those hips rise on leaps, they're showing the full height necessary and extension. 1.5 twist, just a scoot on the landing, so a slight deduction there.
You see the score bug in the lower part of your screen on the right. Florida with a 148.525. Vault is the fastest of the four events, so they are essentially the leaders in the clubhouse. And just for reference, that 148.5 or better is a 9.9 average. So Florida in the third rotation, big time on vault as LSU's Aaliyah Finnegan takes to the floor.
One of the most expressive performers here on floor exercise, and big tumbling here. Double Arabian into a stag jump.
Grace McCallum, the Olympic medalist, now coming back from her injury and to deliver for Utah.
Seen her score a 10 before on this. She has superb technique. Nice straight arm work, beautiful handstand position, and if she can get the stick, this is a big one.
Oh,
there it is. Poulticic double back and a great landing.
That's going to be one of the big stories of this championship, of these biggest names in college gymnastics Trinity Thomas for Florida and Grace McCallum for Utah coming back from injuries to do it for their team.
And Aaliyah is doing a fantastic routine here. Two very difficult tumbling passes.
Audrey Davis will be up on beam for the Sooners. Faith Torres had their second 9-9 plus. So they need two big hit routines here because Florida was lights out on vault in that third rotation.
Beautiful creativity to start this routine. Shows off her flexibility, the balance, the poise that makes this event so special.
Gymnastics fans might remember last year's NCAA championship. Oklahoma opened up on the floor and struggled a bit. They were in fourth place and had to climb back to win the title.
Back handspring layout. Oh, so solid.
And where they won it was on this event, beam.
Front aerial.
Oh, aggressive.
Very elegant, very clean and secure.
How do you find that proper blend between sort of calm and aggressiveness on beam?
Starts day one in your training, when you have the basic training that I can clearly see in extraordinary beam workers' performance. You can trust that gorgeous ring. Very difficult leap when you bend that back leg up and throw your head back. A double twist.
Big score coming up for the Sooners.
And she's been able to stick this.
Oh!
And there it is. That was huge.
Oh, my goodness. The young lady from the Dallas-Fort Worth area in front of a huge crowd here.
Oh, I love the look on her face. After the stick, of course, then she jumped up and down.
Oh, we're just going from greatness to greatness, because guess what? We go to the floor for LSU's Haley Bryant after Aaliyah Finnegan scored a 9.925.
Watch this double front. Always so fun, so difficult, and with great control. Combination pass here. Front layout to a Rudy. Beautiful technique in the air. Nice twisting. Height and excellent extension on the leaps. Great performance. She is such the heart and soul of this team, and she is just a beast in training. Leads by example. Nobody works harder or is as tough in competition as Haley Bryant. Double front, look at the height. You could walk underneath that.
Oh my goodness, after that floor, we go to beam. It's Reagan Smith, also from the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Fans might remember it came down to Reagan Smith last year in a clutch routine to win it for the Sooners on beam of all things. And Audrey Davis before her, a 9.95. Wow.
I love how fast-paced Reagan's beam work is. She really moves across the beam, big steps. Acro series of back handspring layout, step out. Nice height off the beam.
Reagan Smith, a fan favorite. Obviously, she was favored to win the world championships in Montreal. Sprained her ankle in the warm-up gym just before the team marched out. And it's so exciting to see her thrive on beam in college competition.
Watch this combination right here. I love it. Straddle half, right into the back handspring swing down. I love the way she springs off the beam and her shapes in the air. So wonderful.
5'10"s in her career on beam.
After this full turn, a requirement on the balance beam, she sets up her dismount sequence. Check out the amplitude, the way she pops off the beam. Shows the laid out position in this full, flares it out open. Oh, she was a teensy bit ahead of herself.
Oh,
she wanted that stick so bad.
No kidding. Oh. So that will be probably a tenth of a point deduction for a hop like that, Kathy.
Yep, the height was still there, but she just anticipated the landing just a hair too soon.
What a thrilling third rotation. This thing is close, folks. And no bigger highlight than Trinity Thomas getting a 10 on the vault, which means her fifth gym slam of her career. A gym slam is a 10 on every event in one season.
That is a work of art.
Okay, it's been an emotional roller coaster for this young lady, the graduate student, already making history, and she's got one more shot in the final rotation. The Sooners do have the lead, and their head coach is KJ Kindler. She's with Sam now.
Thanks, Bart. KJ, there's a lot of emotions, a lot of craziness happening over here. You're still sitting pretty in first place. What do you think about that?
I mean, it's great. We've really done well tonight. Our energy has stayed up. Still could have caught a couple more things, of course, but I'm proud.
What do you need to do on floor to get the job done here?
I mean, everything. You gotta do everything. You can't win this thing if you don't do everything.
Thanks, KJ.
Thank you.
And Utah's no stranger to the national championship, but they're still trying to find that first win in 28 years. We'll talk to them when we get back to see if this is the year they can close it out.
Welcome back inside Dickey's Arena here at the NCAA Championships, where Florida is trailing Oklahoma by 0.1875. It's a close one here. Utah's head coach, Tom Farden, said that he's actually never been part of a team that's been more intentional than this one, both in and out of the gym. For example, yesterday was their off day, and the team decided to do meditative yoga to help get their head and their bodies right for today's competition. It also doesn't hurt to have Olympic silver medalist Grace McCallum back in the lineups.
This team is intrinsically driven. They do gymnastics from their heart.
I think winning a national title would mean so much to this team. We've worked so hard, and the trust we have in each other this year is just unmatched, and I've never felt something so real. We're just so connected as a team, so I think this year we definitely have a good chance, and you know, this team is something very special.
I think winning a team title for this team would be an amazing accomplishment. You know, we haven't won a team title since 1995. I truly believe that this team as a whole, we've just grown in trust and confidence as the meets have gone on.
We earned our spot here, and we just have to remember going in that we are enough and we've put in the work and we've proven that we deserve this.
Utah hasn't won a championship in 28 years, but one of their athletes has. Abby Brenner was part of the 2021 championship team at Michigan. They won it on the final beam routine, and interestingly enough, the last two championships have been won on the final beam routine. There's some good omens for Utah because not only are they finishing on beam, but they're the number one beam team in the country. Abby Brenner told the team, "Talent gets you to nationals, but character wins championships." She reminded they have both. NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship returns after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Welcome back. Bart Connor along with Kathy Johnson-Clark and Sam Peschek. Oh, we have a great one here with the title on the line at the end of this rotation. Florida, a season high on vault, including that perfect 10 from Trinity Thomas, closed the gap. It's the fourth and final rotation. A reminder, you can watch every event from every team on ESPN+. You get commentary from our stream team. And there they are, John Roethlisberger, Ashley Miles-Greig, and Bridget Sloan. They have you covered all day long on ESPN+. There's also a Spanish feed available. Okay, here we go. Kathy Johnson-Clark, Sloan Blakely from Florida. They trail by less than 0.2 of a point, and they go to the bars.
I'm telling you, somewhere out there, the gymnastics gods must be having a lot of fun because these teams are on their best events.
And Sloan yesterday got only a 9.2375. She'll need to be clutch today.
A critical comeback routine for her. That was where she had the mistake. No problem here. Back-to-back transition elements. Difficult dismount she has planned. Out of this blind change into a double front. She'll need a stick here. Nice and high, and there's the landing.
Oh, how could this get any better? She struggled yesterday and clutched today as Audrey Davis gets the call to lead off the Sooners on floor.
Oklahoma's ranked number 3 in the nation on this event. But as KJ Kindler said, what do you need to do? Everything. Absolutely everything, which starts with landing every single pass with control.
Emily Morgan on beam for Utah at the same time. The number 1 team in the country on beam.
And Utah can be uncanny. They can go lights out on this event, ranked number 1.
Emily has actually never fallen on a beam routine as a gymnast at Utah. She told the coaches one time that she's one of the most determined athletes you'll ever meet. That's why she's been so clutch in this leadoff performance for them, and they need a big one here.
Sophomore from Bristol, England.
And they're just not just solid and consistent in terms of hitting their routines. They're absolutely beautiful on this event.
Oh!
Gainer, front full, and a stuck landing to start this rotation off for them.
How about that? What a leadoff competitor.
This is such a cool dismount. We've seen Gainer back fulls. This is a Gainer front full. Nice twist.
Doria Wynn on bars now. Sloan Blakely, after scoring only a 9.2375 yesterday, notches a 9.925 today when it matters.
What a competition Victoria is having. She's actually doing all 4 events. Little leg separation on that Maloney up to high bar. Nice final handstand. Sets up the dismount here.
Reagan Smith on floor for the Sooners.
Double layout, holds on to the landing. Really excellent job. I only saw that little bit of form. This is such fun choreography. Super upbeat, high energy. One and a half, front layout, right into a nice high bump.
Smith has worked hard to work on the control on her landings. Coach Kindler says sometimes she's a bit of a pogo stick. She needs to control and finesse those landings, doing well so far.
Yes, because the upside to that is the height that she gets off the floor.
Paulson on beam for Utah.
High pike double back for Reagan. A little bit of a hop forward.
Oh, my goodness.
Beautiful extension on those leaps.
Paulson on beam after Emily Morgan led off Utah with a 9.9125.
Abby Paulson has scored a perfect 10 in her beam career, and actually the next three gymnasts in the lineup have also scored a perfect 10. Their scoring potential on this event is unmatched. Of course, they're ranked number one in the country, and head coach Tom Farden says, I believe we have the best beam coach in the country. You're going to see why.
Sam, that really is part of the magic of Utah, the way they work beam as a team.
There is Carly Dockendorf, the coach responsible for their great work on beam, as Kayla DiCello mounts the bars for Florida.
Big Ray, she was a little bit close to the bar, but managed, handled it, swung out of it nicely.
Victoria Wynn before her in 9.9.
Love how she connected that toe handstand out of the pack circle, really raising the level of difficulty. This is a fantastic routine for Florida.
That was a gutsy handstand at the end.
Absolutely.
So aggressive.
And talk about gutsy, connecting those skills. Really, we only see Suni Lee do that. So it was nice to see her up the ante with this routine, and then, of course, come up with a big stick.
Expect their third 9.9 or better for Florida. Owen Field works with their team on bars, is happy with what he's seeing. Okay. Up next will be Trinity Thomas. Her final career performance of her historic NCAA career.
Obviously, this isn't how I wanted things to go, but sometimes things don't go your way, and that's okay. And luckily, I have the best support system, family, friends, teammates, coaches, that have really helped me. So just like fighting through it, regardless of my personal goals, for them, because at the end of the day, like, it's more than gymnastics.
What a moment for one of the greatest of all time in NCAA gymnastics. The graduate student from York, Pennsylvania, had 8 perfect 10s this year, including one on the vault in the last rotation, tied the NCAA record for the most career 10s. This is like a storybook finish, Kim.
It is, and you add the extra layer of what this means to her team in this tight a competition.
And she is set up well, because Kayla DiCello, a 9.975 before her. And we have seen Trinity score 10s on bars before. Oh my.
Trinity is extraordinary with her technique, her form, the precision that she demonstrates so magnificently. And the best part of this routine is right here, the double layout, the rise, the control, that little arm swing. Oh, that was the only thing I saw, because the rest was just astonishing. And what a moment.
Oh. Well appreciated by all in the audience, not just the Gator fans, but everyone, knowing what Trinity Thomas has meant to college gymnastics. Oh my.
Just stellar gymnastics, a beautiful human being who does some of the most beautiful gymnastics work on the planet.
Faye Torres now, the freshman for the Sooners, coming after Jordan Bowers, got a 9.95. So the Sooners with the lead coming into this final rotation already have 3 scores, 9.9 or better.
Big double layout, nice stretched laid out position.
Thank you.
Runs through to double back. Oh, look at the height off the floor. She has more power.
Leanne Wong on bars for Florida now. Just coming after Trinity Thomas, got a 9.9125, the final routine of her career.
Extraordinary work here on the uneven bars, and there is the perfect landing.
What a finish this is becoming. Utah on beam, Florida on bars, the Sooners on floor. And these teams separated by less than 0.2 of a point coming into this fourth and final rotation. Oh! You see in the bottom right that 197.525 is the score for LSU. They are finished with this competition. Vault goes faster than the other events, and so LSU essentially the leader in the clubhouse. But it's going to be between Oklahoma, Florida, and Utah as to who wins that trophy today. Big moment here for Riley McCusker. She has been former national team member, world medalist, transitioned to college, did not compete much, but really coming into her own here at the end of her sophomore year.
It's so wonderful seeing her confidence back because she is a stunning gymnast.
And a 9.9. Qualifying round. Danae Fletcher now for Oklahoma on floor coming after Faith Torres notched another 9.9 or better. It was a 9.925.
Powerful floor routine, powerful music. Whip to double top, much better control than in the semifinals. This is huge for Oklahoma. Punch front layout to full.
Okay, here's perspective on what's going on in the team competition. Danae Fletcher, a 9.925 or better, could clinch the championship for Oklahoma here. And they have one athlete to go after her, would be Danny Severs. Oh my goodness.
Difficult pass right here, 2.5 twists. It's very hard to land with control.
Oh,
and she
yes.
does it to perfection.
That might have done it for the Sooners. They have been impeccable today on floor. Will it be enough to hold off surging Florida and Utah?
She came up so big for them, whipped back so much better than in the semifinals. Yes, she hopped back a little bit. They'll have to take a slight deduction there, because she didn't keep the front foot down, but right here, good control, danced right out, and that final pass was awesome.
Oklahoma going for its sixth championship in 9 years. And needing every bit of those scores. Looking at the scores now, recalculation 9.85 or better will be enough for the Sooners to win it as Miley O'Keefe, who herself scored a perfect 10, in the semifinals, takes to the beam for Utah after Crystal Issa got their 9.95.
The tapestry that Utah can create on balance beam is unmatched. They are just beautiful through and through from one gymnast to the next, and Miley tops them all. In her career, she has come up
with a 10-0 so many times. Look at the extension on the leaps, the perfectly pointed toes, the pictures she makes are awe-inspiring.
Danny Sievers on floor for the Sooners. They're already celebrating over there.
Great routine by Miley, as always.
You know, I picked her in the pre-show as one of those athletes that can score a perfect 10 as she did in the semifinal. The NCAA all-around champion and winner of three individual events as well for Utah.
But soak this in. Everyone is enjoying this final floor routine. And it's a party.
I just cannot remember a more thrilling final rotation with three teams so close.
As I said at the start of the meet, it is their stacked lineups. The way the routines are constructed and prepared, the layers of polish, all there.
The sophomore from South Dakota. And Fletcher's score is in at 9.9375. So regardless of what Sievers gets, the Sooners untouchable. 1.98375. And it could even go up depending on what they give to Danny Sievers. The Sooners now their sixth championship in 9 seasons. And Miley O'Keefe got a perfect 10 for Utah as Grace McCallum, the Olympic medalist coming back from injury, will anchor the Utah Red Rocks on beam.
And she was brilliant in the semifinals. Look at that triple wolf turn into a double wolf. She does those as well as anyone in the world. Beautiful, elegant posture. And the acro series back handspring layout step halt. Superb. Work on the leaps.
Every score for Utah is 9.9125 or better in this final rotation.
Bart, the sign of a good beam worker. She looks 6 feet tall on beam, so stretched up, so precise and polished. Just the dismount, gainer full off the end. Oh, a little hop forward, but oh. So great to see her back in the lineup on these two events.
What a finish to this brilliant competition. The Sooners will receive their sixth championship in 9 seasons. Florida was lights out on bars. Leanne Wong got a 9.975 to go with Takayla DiCellos. Riley McCusker got a 9.925 in that anchor spot. A huge rotation for the Gators, but it was not enough to hold off the Sooners. Oklahoma scores in for Danny Sievers. It's a 9.95. The Sooners untouchable today in Fort Worth, Texas. What a thrilling fourth and final rotation. to cap off an amazing year of gymnastics. We'll be back to wrap this one up in Fort Worth after this. Oh, what a day in Fort Worth. The Sooner have won their sixth of the last nine championships, this time by 15 one-hundredths of a point over the Florida Gators. Utah third, LSU fourth, in a superb final. And a lot had to do with the contributions of Jordan Bowers and Olivia Troutman.
Jordan Bowers was pure brilliance on the floor exercise, hit every pass. An incredible performance with just awe-inspiring height. This is magnificence personified.
And Oklahoma has been here before. Sam Pesek is with Jordan Bowers and Olivia Troutman now.
Congratulations, national champions. KJ Kindler, your head coach, told us it was gonna take everything going into Florida. Did you feel that?
Yes, we rallied together and we just said we know what we have and we're all just gonna come together and do our best gymnastics, and that's exactly what we did.
Olivia, you're a fifth-year senior. Oklahoma has won six championships in 9 years. You're a huge part of that, and you seem to come back at the perfect time every year. How do you do it?
Every moment is just so special, and I wouldn't be able to do it without my trainers, my team, my coaches, my family, and friends. So I'm just here to celebrate with my team and just give it all I got, every last ounce of it, and I'm just excited to be here.
Your coaches told us you wanted it to end in a certain way, your career, of course. Was it worth it?
It was definitely worth it. Night dance, baby!
Thank you.
Thank you.
What a way to cap off an incredible career. Not only the individual title on the vault, but leading the Sooners to a team championship.
Olivia Uncanny Troutman. Just crazy ability to, like a cat in the air, find that landing, drill it into the mat.
They call her the secret weapon for the Sooners. And they will celebrate with the trophy one more time. In just a few hours, they will be back up in Norman, Oklahoma to celebrate with the fans at OU. We'll be back for some final thoughts in Fort Worth in a moment. Wow. Sooners win it again, and Sam Pesek is with their head coach, KJ Kindler.
Congratulations, sixth championship in 9 years. What makes this one special?
Oh my gosh. I mean, they're all so different, but this group of women, they're so incredible. They worked hard together to make this happen. They worked hard from day one in August, and just super proud of them.
You told me after the third event you were a little nervous. Describe your emotions throughout this competition.
Well, yeah, you're always nervous for a national championship. You want it so bad for these ladies. They've worked so hard. So yeah, of course, if I didn't still have those butterflies, something would be wrong with me, I think.
Well, congratulations. Hope you have a good night celebrating.
Thank you so much.
Oh, they're going to be partying back in Norman, Oklahoma. Just think about it. The Sooners have won the last two national championships by a total of less than 0.3 of a point. The quality of gymnastics in the NCAA has never been better.
And it started at the beginning of the season. All these great teams, including the eight that made it here, we watched it in semifinals, they have pushed each other to greatness. So are we surprised this was an epic battle tonight? No, they're extraordinary in every way.
And how do you characterize the contributions of Trinity Thomas from Florida, who not only, you know, set the record or tied the record for NCAA perfect tens, but capped off this illustrious career?
She epitomizes everything you want to see in an athlete: the guts, the resilience, the grace, the, we know all the hard work. What we don't know is all the obstacles that these gymnasts, including Trinity, and mostly Trinity this season going into these final championships, the obstacles they have to overcome to be able to go out there and make it look easy.
Let's take a look at some of her tens in collegiate competition.
This, I've run out of words to really describe the brilliance that we're seeing, the technique, the amplitude, the precision on the landing, just the guts that it took. And the bar is so close. The whole routine she was fighting to show off all the things that Trinity does so well. And just that little arm swing right there, that's all there was.
A vision of greatness. Trinity Thomas, and Sam Peschick is with her now.
Trinity, congratulations, first of all, on a phenomenal career. You tied the perfect 10 record, getting 28 perfect 10s in your career. How did you do it, knowing there was so much pressure on the line?
I was not focused on that at all. I was just focused on being out here one last time with my team. They mean the world to me, and we left it all out here on the floor, and I could not be more proud of us.
Your team was yelling GOAT when you got off the floor for the very last time. How did that make you feel?
Super special. I owe it all to them. Like, I couldn't do it by myself. I can't do anything by myself. So the Lord and my family and friends have helped me all along the way.
You've had such a phenomenal career. How would you sum it up?
I don't even know how to sum it up. It's just been the best time of my life, honestly. The fifth year has been a blessing, and I'm gonna miss gymnastics so much, but I couldn't be more thankful.
Well, I know you left a legacy on this sport, so congratulations, not just today, but for a phenomenal career.
Thank you so much.
Sometimes that word GOAT is overused, but in her case, perfectly appropriate for Trinity Thomas. Oklahoma is the 2023 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Champions. You can watch the trophy ceremony on ESPN+. ABC World News tonight, or your local news, will be coming up on most of these ABC stations, except on the West Coast. This has been a presentation of the NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship on ESPN. For Kathy Johnson-Clark, Sam Peschick, our producer, Carol Lagana, what a thrilling year of gymnastics going back to January 6th. Congratulations to the Sooners, and a great season ends right here in Fort Worth. Thank you so much for watching. So long from Texas.
Finishing in second place with a score of 198.2375, the Florida Gators. Presenting your 2023 NCAA Women's Gymnastics National Champions with a final score of 198.3375, the Oklahoma. Oklahoma Sooners! This year's Women's Gymnastics Championship. We'll see you right back here in Fort Worth next year. Good night, God bless, and we'll see you down the dusty trail.